Hello students, welcome back. This is Vittal Mamilla and my YouTube channel is Vittal Mamilla e-classroom. So I think in the previous video you have seen what is the introduction of real numbers. Now let us see the second concept, Euclid division lemma, and the problems related to Euclid division lemma, and also the 4-mark questions which are being asked in the public examinations. Okay, so first, in the real numbers we are seeing exercise 1.1. in this the main concept is Euclid division lemma and finding the HCF using Euclid division lemma and some problems related to Euclid division lemma. Now let us see what is Euclid division lemma. So in the Euclid division lemma, first, given any two positive integers a and b, that means there are two positive integers will be given, that numbers are a and b, then there exist unique pair of integers q comma r satisfying a is equal to bq plus r, a is equal to bq plus r. So first let us understand till here. What is given is, so there are two numbers are given. What are the numbers? A and B are two numbers given. Then Q and R, two unique pair of integers are coming. How they are coming? Let us see. Let us take one example. So say 5 and 3. In the 5 and 3, always you take the bigger number as A and the smaller number as B. So let us take A is equal to 5. And b is equal to 3. A is equal to 5 and b is equal to 3. So here, till here we are understanding. Now given any two positive integers a and b, so the two positive integers are 5 and 3, numbers are given. Now let us see the next one. So if we divide 3 with 5, normal division, 3 ones are 3 and the remainder is 2. So 3 ones are 3 and the remainder is 2. So here we are stopping. Just observe it. 3 and 5 are given numbers. Already we supposed A is 5 is A and this is B. 3 is B. And in the normal division, what we will call 5 and 3? 5 is dividend and 3 is divisor. 5 is dividend and 3 is divisor. So always we will take like this, dividend, and we will divide it by divisor. Then what we will get? 3 ones the 3. And this 1 is called as, what we will call 1 as? Quotient. 1 we will call it as quotient. So here we will get as quotient. And after that, the final 2 we are getting as remainder. 2 is what? Remainder. 2 is remainder. So after dividing, what we are getting? The value which we are getting, we call it as remainder. We will call it as remainder. So if you observe, here A and B are two numbers given, and this 1 we will take it as Q, and 2 we are taking as R. So 1 and 2 we are taking it as Q and R. So while dividing any two numbers, we will get quotient and remainder uniquely. If you observe here, there exists a unique pair of integers Q, R. Q is a quotient, R is a remainder. So till here understand it. Given any two pair of integers A and B, then there exist a unique pair of integers Q and R. Now let us see what is the equation. What is the equation? Already we know that divisor, dividend, quotient and remainder. We know the division algorithm in the previous classes. How we will write it? Generally we will write it, dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This you know already, right? Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Now let us substitute. Dividend means what we supposed? It is A. The dividend, whatever we are dividing D, is we are taking it as A. And divisor is B. Divisor is B. So these two numbers are given numbers. Then what we are getting? We are getting Q is as quotient and R is as remainder. So now just observe, it is as A is equal to BQ plus R. So every given, if any two positive numbers are given, then it satisfies A is equal to BQ plus R. Right, till here you understand. Now the second one is, where 0 less than or equal to R less than B. We'll understand that. What is 0 less than or equal to R less than B? So in this, let us see one, let us take example. Suppose if I divide some 3 with 7. 3 with 7, what we should get? I will get Q and R. So 3 2s are 6. The remainder is 1. If I take one more number, 3 with 6, what I will get? 3 2s are 6 and the remainder is 0. One more number I will take, 3 8s are 3 and 8, 3 2s are 6 and the remainder is 2. So here the main important thing is, whatever the divisor, divisor we are taking as 3 here. Then what is the remainder we are having? In the first case we are having remainder as 2. And the second case remainder is 1 and the third case remainder is 0. If you take any other number like 3 and 6, 7, 8, we have taken 9, let us take. If I take 9, 3, 3 is a 9, it is again 0. That means whatever the number you divide with 3, either you will get 0 or 1 or 2. Right? 0, 1 or 2. So always remainder, if you observe, the remainder is equal to 0, we are getting remainder as is equal to 0, and the remainder is we are getting as greater than 0, greater than 0, and the next one is remainder is less than B. B is nothing but 3. B is nothing but 3. Now just observe this 3, R is equal to 0, R greater than 0. If I combine these two, I will get R is greater than or equal to 0. Always remainder is greater than or equal to 0, and we are having here R is less than B. So if R is greater than or equal to 0, R else I can write R is greater than 0 means 0 is less than R, both are same, right? If R is greater than 0, I can write 0 is less than or equal to R. And the next one we are having is R is less than B. So R is less than B. If I combine these two, I am getting 0 less than or equal to R less than B. So that is the second condition. So in the Euclid division lemma, what we are having, always remainder lies between 0 and the dividend, which is B. 0 and dividend B. Okay, understand now? Now let us see once again. What is Euclid division lemma? First, any two positive integers will be given. A and B are two positive integers. Then we will get Q and R. Q and R, two unique pair of integers. Satisfying the equation is A is equal to BQ plus R, where 0 less than or equal to R less than B. The most important in this, whenever they ask Euclid division lemma, you should remember that the equation is A is equal to BQ plus R, where 0 less than or equal to R less than B. Now let us see how to find HCF using Euclid division lemma. So this is so many times asked for 1 mark or sometimes 2 marks. So what is Euclid division lemma? I think you understand. The Euclid division lemma is, given any two positive integers A comma B, there exist Q comma R, satisfying A is equal to BQ plus R, where 0 less than or equal to R less than B. That means A is equal to BQ plus R, 0 less than or equal to R less than B. This is the condition for Euclid division lemma. Now, by using this, we will find out the LCF of given any two numbers. The example let us take now, 50 and 70. They will give question like this, find LCF of 50 and 70 using Euclid division lemma. Okay, so how to write it now? We should convert this into A is equal to BQ plus R form. We convert this into A is equal to BQ plus R form. Now, if you observe it, let us divide in the normal division 50 and 70. 50 and 70. Then 50 ones are 50. I am getting as 20 is remainder. So, by applying the Euclid division lemma, let A is equal to 70, the bigger number should be A and the smaller number is B. Bigger number is A and smaller number is B. Then by Euclid division lemma, what I can write? A is equal to BQ plus R. A is equal to BQ plus R. So what is A here? 70. B is what? 50. And Q is, what the Q we will get? Q is 1 plus 20. Right? 70 is equal to 50 into 1 plus 20. If you observe this, 50 into 1 is 50 plus 20 is 70. Both are equal. So, we are writing it in the form of A is equal to BQ plus R. But here, what is R? R is 20. R is 20. To find the HCF, what we need is, R should be 0. We should make this R is 0. How we will make it? In the continuous division of the factors. So let us take it. So 20 is a remainder which is not 0. Now I should make this 20 as 2 in the further division process. As already you know how to find the HCF in the lower classes by using this method. Okay. So now what I will do? The remainder will become divisor. The remainder will become divisor and the divisor will become dividend. So, 50. What is happening here? Remainder is becoming, in the next step, remainder is becoming divisor and the previous divisor is becoming dividend. Divisor is becoming dividend. So in the second process, 20 is a divisor and I am bringing this 50 to dividend. So now let us divide this 22 is a 40. Again the remainder is 10. Now remainder is 10 but it is not 0. So, we should continue this process until the remainder is 0. Until the remainder is 0. Now, 10. Again, 10. I should make this as 10 is remainder. We are changing it into divisor. And previous 20, I am bringing into dividend. 10, 2 is a 20. Remainder is 0. Remainder has come 0. So this is the easiest way to find out the HCF. Already you know that. In the previous classes you learned how to find the HCF. Here what will be your HCF? The HCF will be by what divisor it is becoming 0. What divisor remainder is becoming 0. That divisor you should take it as HCF. This will be your HCF. So by using this process, let us write in the Euclid division lemma. So the first one already this we written, 70 is equal to 50 into 1 plus 20. Okay. In the second one I should write this one. What is the A means 50 is equal to 20 into 2 plus 10. And the third one is for 10 is a dividend. 10 is a divisor. So I should take 20 is equal to 10 into 2 plus 0. So we should continue this process until we get R as
0.
Until we get R as
0.
So if R is coming 0, then the whatever the dividend, whatever the divisor we are getting, this 10 will be the HCF of given 50 and 70. So therefore, HCF of 50 and 70 is 10. 50 and 70 is 10. So did you understand? First, whatever the numbers are given, you should take it as the bigger number as A and the smaller number as B. Then by Euclid division lemma, you know that A is equal to BQ plus R. A is equal to BQ plus R. So 70 is equal to, you can write 50 into 1 plus 20 in the first case. So we should make this, we should continue this process until remainder becomes 0. Right? So 50 into 1 plus 20 in the second step. I should take 50 into 50 here, 50 is equal to 20 into 2 plus 10. In the third step, 20 is equal to 10 into 2 plus 0. So in this step, we got remainder as 0. So remainder is 0 by what divisor? The divisor is 10. And the divisor will become HCF of 50 and 70. Okay? So in the rough, you just better to write for this rough work. Because some students, what they will do is, they will do this process and they will write HCF is 10, which is wrong, because this is the previous questions, or in fact previous methods. Now they asked us to do by using Euclid division lemma. I should do in this process only. So directly I can write this process, but which makes some little bit difficult. That is why first I am writing in the previous manner, then I am converting this to Euclid division lemma. Okay, and better to write here rough, otherwise you will make keep like that only. So many students will keep like that only and they will write HCF as 10. For that they will lose the marks, because the examiner asked you find by using Euclid division lemma. Okay, let us take one more example. The one more example is, the previous in 2018 the one question have come, that is 24 and 33. Find the HCF of 24 and 33 using Euclid division lemma. So you know that let A is equal to the bigger number and the B is equal to the smaller number, then by Euclid division lemma, what you know that A is equal to BQ plus R, 0 less than or equal to R less than B is the Euclid division lemma. Now if I substitute here, 33 is equal to 24 into what I can write here. So let us do in the rough process. The rough process is the normal division method. 24, let us divide with 33. 24 ones are 24. The remainder will be 24, 6, 9. Then again 9, I am doing with 24. 9 2s are 18. 6 again by 9. 6 1s are 6. Remainder is 3. 3 2s are 6. Here coming as 0. So how many steps it have come? This is the first step, and this is the second one, and this is the third one, and this is the fourth one. So in the HCF also we will get four steps here. So first one is 33 is equal to 24 into 1 plus the remainder. So 24 into 1 plus 9. Now always this divisor becomes dividend and remainder becomes, so 24 is equal to, and this remainder will come as divisor. So 9 into 2 plus 6. Same, the third one is 9 is equal to 6 into 1 plus 3. What I am writing, just observe here. First one is, I am taking this division. So 33 is equal to 24 into 1 plus remainder. 24 into 1 plus remainder. Next second divide. Second one I am taking as 24 will be your dividend. 24 your dividend. 9 into 2 is 18 plus remainder is 6. Remainder is 6. So we should continue this process until we get remainder as 6. Now remainder as 0. Now 9. The third one is 9 as a dividend. 9 is equal to 6 into 1 plus 3. Still the remainder is not 0. So again the third, last one is, fourth one is, I should take 6 is equal to 3 into 2 plus 0. Now here 0 has come here as remainder. By which divisor it is coming as 0? The divisor is 3. And the 3 will be the HCF of given 2. The 0 is coming as remainder. So therefore, the HCF of 24 and 33 is 3. Okay, I can write as HCF of 24 and 33 is 3. How we did it? First, 33 is equal to 24 into 1 plus 9. Then the divisor becoming dividend and the remainder is becoming divisor. Same way for everything. Here, until the remainder comes 0, we should continue the process. We should continue the process until remainder comes 0. So again, 9 comes dividend and 6 comes divisor. 6 comes dividend and 3 comes divisor. And the final it has come 0. So whenever remainder comes 0, we should stop the process. And whatever the divisor is there, that divisor becomes HCF. Okay, then now let us see one more example. Suppose two numbers are given, 270 and 900. 270 and 900 and two numbers. Find the HCF of 270 and 900. How to do it? First, let A is equal to 900 and B is equal to 270. So I should write as 900 is equal to 270 into how much? To find this, let us do in the rough. 270 divided by 900. Then 270 how much? 3 is 270, 3 is 810. Remainder is 90. So 90, if I take 270, then 3 is 270, remainder is 0. The remainder has come with divisor as 90. So 900 is equal to, I can write 270 into 3 plus 90. Then 270 becomes your dividend and 90 becomes your divisor, 90 into 3 plus 0. So the remainder become 0. Whenever the remainder is become 0, the divisor will be your HCF. So therefore, the HCF of 270 and 900 is how much? It is 90. Based on this, you can do some more problems. In the textbook, they have given 1860-2015. This you can change it to 1860-2020 also, because the textbook might be written in the 2015. They have given question as 2015. Now you are in the 2020, you can take 1860 and 2020. Find the HCF of this. Or else you can do one more problem like that. Your date of birth, suppose your date of birth is 2006, suppose 2006, and you can take 2020. So you do this problems and find out the HCF of these two numbers by using Euclid division lemma. Okay, so this is about Euclid division lemma, how to find the HCF using Euclid division lemma. In the next video, let us see
the problems related to Euclidean division lemma, which are 4 marks problems. Okay.